So let's start with a balance exercise. Just crossing to the front and to the back. And notice here how the upper body is not trying to hold on to a stiffening position, but it will allow for adjustments to be able to support the movement of the legs. So try to find that fine balance where you're not completely relaxed, but at the same time you're not stiff. So it is always a matter of, what is the focus of this exercise? Is this a focus to see how long we can stay over one leg? That can be a great focus, but for our tango purposes, where we are constantly moving from one foot to another and we're passing from these positions, it is important also to see how the passing can happen smoothly. So if you want to make this into an embellishment, you can start traveling upward like I'm doing here. And of course, you wouldn't be taking this long in your dance to do this, but we're using the embellishment itself as a balance exercise. So maybe you want to keep it lower. Maybe you want to go higher than where I'm going. Maybe you want to use the wall or a bar or a table for support. The other way to go is to go behind and wrap your way up and make your way back down. So if, again, you don't have to travel all that way up, you can stop anywhere you like along the line of your leg. The idea here is not to just do the embellishment, just to do the embellishment. You want to allow for some personal, it's objective, that's what I mean to say. You want to allow for your personality to show up in the embellishments, let's put it that way. So this might not be something that interests you, and that would be one. And two, you want to have your focus set to, I'm going to use this embellishment to better understand how balance works and to understand balance as proper alignment and balanced energy. So how much energy am I using? How much energy am I spending just to do these movements? And is there a more efficient, a more balanced way to do this movement, a way that different parts of my body are supporting instead of stiffening up, so that which would be something that would allow me to do this movement in a more efficient, more energy balanced way. So that is my goal, and I'm hoping that you would make that your goal as well, not only with this video but with all the videos that we do, because then, especially with embellishments, it becomes very annoying when you're trying to put something in, and even though that something is supposed to make your dance more enjoyable and more fun, it is actually making you feel like you're working super hard, that you're tensing up, and that you're causing more trouble to your partner than, making your dance fun and spicy and enjoyable for both. So these are some things that you want to think about while doing these exercises, when you don't have to worry too much about how the other person is interpreting these movements. So we're going to see here how we can use these embellishments in or during our dance moves, such as our walks and our ochos. And I want you to know a couple of things here. I am not rushing through my step just to get the embellishment in. That's quite important, not only when you're dancing, but also when you're practicing this. You want to be ready. So here you land and you prepare the base and you do the embellishment. At the tail end of the embellishment, you want to check, see here, and then go. See how I'm not just going from the embellishment straight into that projection. Let's see it again. And then go. You secure the base, and it might take you a couple of times, especially if you're working on heels, to find that safe stance where you're solid, and you go. It is a very critical moment, and that projection. And it is a moment where we see a lot of bad habits that happen. How we swing the leg through, how we shift the weight. Let's see it again here. So I'm allowing for that full swing to happen. I'm not just gonna step here. I'm gonna go in and swing out. And even if we were to bypass a few dots here, which would be allowed, I would still want to create that central sense of changing directions, going from a, let's see, cross position, see how this is a cross position, to a position where I'm expanding backwards or forwards and I'm ready to step. So I'm allowing my body to become more aware of the necessary transitions between all the movements that are happening here. So use this exercise to learn a different embellishment or two different embellishments, but also to become more aware. And so, of course, we're gonna take this awareness and bring it into our ochos. We start with regular forward ochos just to set up a pace and allow for ourselves to acknowledge the flow of the step itself. And then we're gonna try to not disrupt the flow, but add a little bit of an enrosque, you know, an extra little thing, especially for the leaders, but followers, you can use that too. You see that I am slowing down, but I'm not disrupting the flow. I don't want to get stuck here. So notice how the leg comes in and let's see, the leg comes in, the body is going, and we start to circle around. So the two are connected, you see? Let's see, connected. You don't come to the cross and then try to give yourself the lead for the pivot, see? I've already started preparing myself for that pivot, so one naturally leads to the other, and the two movements are not disconnected. See again? So we're going in and up and around at the same time. Yep. Let's see again. In, up, and around at the same time. So you want to have that same feeling. Maybe it's a little bit more of a tight feeling compared to this, but it's exactly, can you see how it is exactly the same motion, only our feet are crossed. But it's exactly the same, it's exactly the same idea, better said. Exactly the same idea, upper and lower body working together, seamlessly creating a step and a turn. So if we were to cross the legs instead of passing through like we're normally doing, that will naturally lead to a similar flowy ocho, only slightly embellished. And then, of course, this is a little bit more for the followers. You can start playing with that cross and see if you can create a little bit of a wrap. But in order to do this and not get stuck, you need to establish that that coordination between legs and hips and body. So the embellishment itself will force you, in order for it to happen smoothly and not make you feel tense, will force you to notice these details. And this is another great reason why we're using embellishments here and in our practices. We can learn a new embellishment, but at the same time, you are forced, you're invited to notice details that you might have been skipping through during your regular ochos. Similarly, if you go to a back ocho, you want again to start from this, setting up the base, just to be a little bit aware. Now you're carrying the experience of the forward ocho, so it works in exactly the same. They work exactly in the same way. Might be a little bit more challenging, but use the experience you got from the forward ochos. Use it here in the back ochos. And try to find, again, that coordination between the lower and the upper body prior to getting to this stage where you start crossing, getting the legs up, flicking, wrapping, doing all sorts of fancy stuff. The fanciness is not the goal. The becoming aware and freeing yourself up from all the things you have to think about during dancing will allow you to be expressive, to find embellishments of your own, to be inspired and to feel creative on the dance floor. So use these exercises. Go slower maybe than what I'm doing. Spend more time to working on certain things. Don't worry about completely following, 100% following the video in terms of pace, but try to make the flow your focus. Not to avoid the glitches, to clean up your dance and enhance your awareness.